Friends, today we are having this Coolpad Note 3S in our hand, and today we shall see that what are the good and bad pros and cons of this, whether you should go for purchasing this phone or not. So first we take the pros of this phone. So the first thing is that its design, and as far as this design of the phone is concerned, the company has given a very good design. And it is a aluminium chassis in which this plastic back beautifully fitted, and this plastic back gives a feel of metal finish, and overall design and look and feel of the phone is very good. Therefore, as far as design is concerned, this phone is very good. And second is RAM. This phone is having 3 GB RAM and 32 GB internal, which is also very good. And third is gaming and multitasking experience. Gaming experience is reasonably well, however multitasking experience is very good. The phone performs all your tasks simultaneously even after a low type and old type of processor. Then friends, comes this 5.5 inch display. Since it is a large display and capacitive buttons are given below this screen size on the chin, therefore this entire 5.5 display is available for the user. Then we comes to this fingerprint, and this fingerprint is available in most of the phone, but the fingerprint is very good and it performs very well, and it unlocks immediately as soon as you lift the finger on the back of the phone. And now next we come to this Android version. Out of the box, this phone runs on Android 6.0. So that is also a good thing that the phone runs on 6.0 out of the box. Then this phone also supports 4G VoLTE. I have tested and I have done a video on that. So this phone also supports 4G LTE. So these are the pros of the phones. Now we come on the bad part of this phone. So the weak part of this phone is the battery. If we go to the battery, then this phone is having very weak battery. However, it is 2500 mAh, but the phone does not support for the whole day. You have to charge it within 7 to 8 hours after normal usage, and in case of heavy usage it will last for 5 to 6 hours. So battery is the weak part. Then camera. The camera of the phone is also very average, rather I will say below average in this price segment, because the camera quality of other phones in the same price range is giving better quality than this phone. Then comes to display. The display of the phone, the color reproductions are also very faint. If you see the wallpaper, then the wallpaper is presently giving a very faint type of display. So the display of the phone is also a very weak part. Then this protection. Protection is not given by Gorilla Glass, and it is a normal glass. Then no NFC is there and no IR blaster. So these are the cons of the phone. And still, if the phone is available at ₹8,500, then I'll say it may be a good buy. Thanks for watching. I'll come with some other video. Thanks.